Hey everyone. In this video, we're going to be walking through and understanding the theory behind the trapezoid rule for numerical integration. So, as we've been learning, numerical integration is a numerical technique that can allow us to take a function like e to the power of negative x squared, which cannot be solved analytically, and allow us to approximate the area under the curve by creating subintervals of easy to calculate areas, and then adding all those areas together. As the name implies, the trapezoid rule creates trapezoids as our subinterval areas. For now, let's just assume that all our trapezoidal segments are of the same width. We would then sum up all these areas to get the approximate total area under the curve, which you can see here. The validity of this assumption will depend on how much error we get, which is the sum of all these little chopped off areas that you can see here. You can think of it like this. The blue area here is our exact area under the curve between points A and B, that being the definite integral of our function between A and B. Then adding areas A1 and A2 together approximately gives us the same area. Then, the difference between the two sides of our approximate sign here will be our trapezoid rule error term, which is all the overestimation and underestimation error we briefly mentioned earlier. This error will be talked about in a future video, but just keep it in mind. Now, let's look at our trapezoids here, and remember how to find the area of a trapezoid. The area of each trapezoid is going to be 1/2 times our width, which is just delta x, or x1 minus xo for our a1 here, times the left height of our trapezoid plus the right height of our trapezoid. And I hope this drawing here makes that more clear. Now that we have an understanding of what the trapezoid rule is, why we use it, and how we calculate the area of trapezoids, let's work out our actual trapezoid rule. So, let's create a small sketch here on the left and assume three areas that are all of equal sizing of delta x. We say that the exact integral is approximately equal to area 1 plus area 2 plus area 3. Area 1 is going to be 1/2 times our delta x times our two heights added together, which is simply our function evaluated at x0 plus the function evaluated at x1. Then we will continue this process for trapezoids area 2 and 3. To put this into summation notation, the trapezoid rule looks like this. You could also move the 1/2 outside of the summation term, or if you have equal spacing, the delta x and the 1/2 can be both moved outside the summation term. However, this notation is more general. Briefly, I just want to add if we were to increase our number of subintervals, n, to a limit approaching infinity, we are going to approach a limit. That is the exact answer to the area under the curve. Recall the blue area from earlier. So, the more subintervals we have, the more accurate our answer will be using the trapezoid or any other numerical integration technique. Lastly, let's expand out the summation notation for unequal and equal spacings. Firstly, for the unequal spacings, we're just going to basically have the same equation that we developed earlier, with the delta x term now being expanded and explicitly showing our x terms. This is because we are saying that the difference between all these terms is not equal. So, for our three areas, this is what the trapezoid rule would look like. Alternatively, when we have equal spacing, we get an interesting trend. Using our previously derived equation, I'm just going to highlight some common terms. In green, we have all of our common factors. Then, the remaining colors are just to show our equivalent terms. Therefore, all the green terms can now be factored out. As you can see, all of the internal x values, so x1 and x2 in this example, appear twice, as they are used in both neighboring trapezoid area calculations, whereas our external data points, so x0 and x3, only appear once. Therefore, with equal spacing, we get a much simpler looking equation that looks like this. I hope that this video helped your understanding of what the trapezoid rule is used for, how we go about finding it, and why it's useful in numerical integration. If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.